Welcome back to Fox 8 News in the Morning. Adoption is something that touches all people and all cultures, crosses all backgrounds. And this week, several authors are coming together in an effort to help the Adoption Network. They are presenting family reflections. Authors share their stories, and we are very, very honored to have Paula McLain here. She is here this morning to share her connection to adoption in the foster care system. She is a best-selling author, and she lives in Cleveland now, which is a wonderful thing. First of all, welcome to Fox 8 News in the Morning.
Thank you so much. I'm delighted to be here.
Tell me about the event. Why you're taking part and what it's for, the Adoption Network event.
Right. So the Adoption Network is partnering with a group of authors who are coming together to discuss.
Got six authors coming together.
Exactly, who all have some connection to adoption or foster care, to raise awareness for this population so greatly in need in our own community.
And the Adoption Network is just that support system for families who, you know, have foster children, who have adopted children, that type
Absolutely,
of thing.
Absolutely, to provide advocacy communication and networking, workshops, and to support this population who very much needs it.
Tell us about your story.
So my story, when I was 4 years old, my mother took us to my grandmother's house and said she was going to the movies.
Picture right here.
And then didn't come back.
Just you and your sisters?
That's right. That's me in the middle. I was four. My younger sister Penny was three. My sister Teresa was six. And she never came back. She was gone for 16 years. My father was in prison at the time. Both were struggling with drug addiction.
And oftentimes that's the case when parents give up their kids, you know, maybe it's drug addiction or something like that
Absolutely.
That they're going through at the time.
Right. Mm-hmm. Well, my mother was only 21 at the time and had three kids and very little education, no resources. It's been, you know, certainly it was a really difficult way to grow
to
up.
Were you in foster home after foster home?
So I spent 14 years in foster care from the time I was four until I aged out of the system.
Difficult?
At 18, incredibly difficult. The dislocation, the displacement, the ongoing uncertainty, bouncing through various homes without any idea of where we would go next or how long we would stay in any placement. It's incredibly challenging.
You wrote a memoir. Which is, you've several books, New York Times bestseller, and all of that. But
you wrote
a memoir, and that was what living in other people's home. What's it called?
Right. So in 2003, I published a memoir called Like Family, Growing Up in Other People's Houses,
and it
really is just my story, the story of how I came through the system and the various homes that we were in. And you know, Wayne, most people who come out of foster care don't have the resources, but also I think the fact that I could tell my story as an adult when I couldn't tell it as a child was incredibly empowering.
When you were a kid, did you write at that time? Did you start writing as a child?
I did. I always wrote as a way to process my feelings, my difficult feelings. Yeah. I wrote poetry before I ever really even knew.
So it was a way of you kind of releasing,
just
processing your feelings, which is
absolutely
important.
And then as an adult, I decided to get a degree in creative writing.
Okay.
And so
now talk about
sort of developed the tools to be able to tell my story.
Very successful. You aged out of the system.
Right.
And people say that's such a difficult thing to do.
Oh, it felt impossible at the time because you age out of the system and suddenly you have no net and no resources and no support. And I tell you, that was really the most precarious time. It's a really vulnerable time. I worked in a nursing home for less than $3 an hour. I had no bank account,
How'd you get through that?
No health insurance, no car insurance, and the only way I was able to even get an education was because at that time in California, for $50 a semester plus books, you could go to any community college in the state of California.
So that turned out to be a blessing
and
for
you. And so that was everything. It still took me 7 years to get a bachelor's degree. I was supporting myself full time. You know, I dropped out maybe three or four different times before I was able to get a degree, but kept fighting.
Perseverance.
Yeah.
You had it in here. You had it in your heart, it seems.
I think so.
Because
didn't feel empowerment coming from elsewhere. I empowered myself.
Real quickly, this is off the subject. I want to talk. You have a best-selling, The Paris Wife. That's a great, great book. There it is right there.
Thank you.
And
So in the last 10 years, I've been working on publishing historical fiction.
Historical fiction,
Right. Yes. Yeah. And writing is my... has been a huge part of my healing process and my identity and strengthening my voice.
Well, you are a tremendous success story. You really
Thank
are.
You, Wayne.
And an inspiration to others who are going through the system, no doubt.
Thank
and
you.
Once again, it's tomorrow night you're going to be at the...
It's actually on Wednesday night.
Wednesday night. Tomorrow,
at
Day's
the Music
Monday,
Box,
on Wednesday. Thank you.
Right, between 6 and 9. Tickets are still available,
Excellent.
And they'll be available at the door. So we'd love to see you there.
That is so very, very nice. You're incredible.
Thank you.
And a wonderful writer.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for stopping
Thanks
by.
Thanks for having
Appreciate
me.
It.